Hi, welcome to the glass plate. Today we're going to take an example out of ordinary life, at least for Dutch. We're going to think about what is called a Dutch croquette. It's a small spherical type of croquette that has a diameter of about 3 centimeters, and that is a pretty popular snack at parties and drinks. It is made by putting it in boiling oil. So it comes out of the oil at a temperature of 117 degrees Celsius. And then it's placed in a surrounding of about 20 degrees Celsius. And sure, you get one offered. You pick it up. The outside is hot, but not really. You can hold it. And you're anxious to take a bite. But you realize that it just came out of boiling oil of 117 degrees. Now, to be able to eat and bite this, we're going to estimate. If the average temperature is 40 degrees Celsius, then we would be fine. It's hot, but not too. How long should you wait if they offer you one? Let's make our estimates. What do we know? Heat conduction on the inside, unsteady, sphere, short or long times? Long times. The starting temperature has disappeared when you reach these average temperatures, so it's long times. We're going to assume that this temperature reaches all the way up to the interface. In that case, we can use the graphs. Dimensionless temperature against dimensionless time. Okay, so first we need to compute the dimensionless temperature as required. Hence, the average temperature minus the 20 degrees wall temperature divided by the initial temperature minus the wall temperature. That is 40 minus 20 over 170 minus 20, which is roughly 0.14. Once we have that, we need the graph that shows the average temperature versus dimensionless time. So we read off at a value of 0.14 for this dimensionless time what the Fourier number is. If we do that, we get a Fourier number from the graph of about 0.03. And this is equal to A, the thermal diffusivity, the time that we would like to compute, divided by the diameter squared. Okay, so we need a number. For most foods, it holds that they have properties water-like, and thus A is 1.4 10 to the minus 7 meter square per second. Then I can compute out of this the cooling time required. That's about 200 seconds. So you need to wait at least a couple of minutes. But don't be fooled. Now the average temperature is 40 degrees. What if you bite in this? This goes in your mouth, you give it a bite, and sure, the inside, so the stuff sitting here really internally, will spread out over your tongue. And the question is, at this time, what is this center temperature? Is that also close to 40 degrees? Then it's fine. If not, I'm not so sure why it should not wait any longer. Okay. We can find that just by looking at the center temperature. So I pick my other graph, the center temperatures. Here it is. And I do the reverse. Now I know that the dimensionless temperature is sitting here at 0.03, and I read off the line for the center temperature, dimensionless for a sphere. If I do that on this graph, get that Tc minus the wall temperature over the initial temperature minus the wall temperature is 0.5. And thus, the center temperature equals T1 plus 0.5 times the original temperature difference. And this is 150 degrees. Half of that is 75, plus the 20 from the outside. Oops, the inside is still has temperatures comparable to boiling water. Sure enough, if you bite after 200 seconds in this lovely croquette, you will burn your mouth. And sure enough, most Dutch have done this. Compute for yourself how long you need to wait for this temperature to drop to something like 50 degrees.